I'm Mixer Giant and this is Top 10 Comic Books. Number 1, Identity Crisis. Deadpool, Spider-Man, and the Hulk were sent to another dimension. Deadpool made a new best friend, but then he was destroyed by Deathmask, so Deadpool destroyed Deathmask. Then they found out they need to save this world's Banner from this world's Hulk, because this world's Banner, it banners the Hulk to the underworld, but when and their Hulk went there, he switched with the Inferno Hulk. The spell was reversed and their Hulk tricked the Inferno Hulk into breaking the Eye of Atamoto. Number 9, Spider-Verse. Yes, the multiverse is safe, and Uncle Ben from another dimension is going to stay with Peter Parker's daughter to do what Uncle Ben has never gotten the chance to do, be a grandfather. Her father, Peter Parker, didn't survive, but Mary Jane told her to do what her father wanted her to do, become Spider-Woman, and she gave her the original Spider-Man costume. Number 8, The Blackest Night. The Justice League needs to fight against and Black Lantern zombies of supervillains and superheroes. We get to see them fight death itself, and we're together with life itself. Number 7, Brightest Day. A Swamp Thing makes a grave, gave out a plan to honor dead man for what he did for him. And all of the lanterns find out that the Green Lantern's oath turns out to be a prophecy. And then you stop the entities of their cores and trap them into their lantern cores again. We get to see how Jordan get back together with Carol Ferris. We get to see Sinestro back into the lantern. We get to see Green Lantern how Jordan get back into the Green Lanterns. We also get to see the debut of two new Green Lanterns and all of the lanterns working together, and Atrocitus finally gets his revenge on the Guardians. Because after their first release first, the Guardians destroyed his home. Atrocitus destroyed them. Then they went to the Green Lanterns. Number 6, Batman Endgame. The Joker has stolen all of Batman's weapons, and he's using them for parade floats. Now Batman needs to work with his greatest enemies to stop the Joker, because they want to rule Gotham City. They don't want to see it fall. When Batman fought the Joker, they were both beaten pretty badly, then the cave fell on them. But then, an espresso chemical healed both of them. But also here, the mental pain of Batman, which means he doesn't remember being Batman. Gotham City filled the night skies with bats and was hoping for their savior to return. Number 5, Batman Super Heavy. Gotham needs Batman back. Luckily, Batman planned for this and he built a machine and to give himself all of his memories back. And not only is it the return of Batman, the Caped Crusader, the Dark Knight, the world's greatest detective, the Bat of Gotham, it is also the return of hope and justice, and we get to see Commissioner Gordon get his job back. Number 4, Suicide Squad vs. the Justice League. Not only do we get to see a bunch of superhero vs. supervillain battles, we also get Maxwell Lord breaking out the first Suicide Squad, and now the Justice League and the Suicide Squad need to work together to defeat him. After stealing an artifact from Bellwebs, he gets mind controlled by someone, and that someone also mind controls the Justice League. They manage to defeat him by using Kerouac's eyes to magnify Superman's heat vision into sunlight. After Kerouac and Lobo helped the Justice League, Batman offered them into the Justice League. It also shows us the origin story of how Lobo and Kerouac got into the Justice League, and how Batman made his own Justice League. Number 3, Justice League Dark Side War. The Justice League have been turned into gods and they're fighting with each other. We also get to see Darkseid versus the Anti-Monitor. We also get to see the Black Racer, the God of Death, kill Darkseid. The Justice League start being gods and they defeated Darkseid's daughter. Number 2, World War Hulk. Iron Man, Doctor Strange, Black Bolt, and Mr. Fantastic thought the Hulk was too dangerous, so they sent him into space. He freed an alien planet, then they made him his leader. He had a wife and an unborn child, until the chip that brought him to that planet exploded, destroying most of his planet, his wife, and his unborn child. He went back to Earth to get revenge. He broke Doctor Strange's hands. And then Doctor Strange was at full power weight, and the Hulk still beat him. He defeated the Ghost Rider. And he defeated both the entire Avengers team and the whole Avengers. And he defeated every heavy hitter superhero team in the Marvel Universe, basically. But then it turns out it was one of his new subjects that had made his ship explode. Oh, then the Hulk got so angry he almost exploded with anger, literally. Then it took a satellite blast made by Iron Man in order to defeat him. But then the Hulk did redeem himself. Before in VR topic, here's a few honorable mentions. Number 1, Marvel vs. DC. Two brothers that are the physical embodiment of everything in their universe is decided they wanted to find out who was special. So they took all of the best heroes and villains into both universes and made them fight each other. We get to see Deadpool vs. Deathstroke. We get to see Deathstroke vs. Captain America. And we get to see Batman save Captain America's life. We get to finally see who's stronger, Superman or the Hulk. We get to see Wonder Woman use Thor's hammer. Yeah, she becomes the God of Thunder, but then she has to fight Storm, and she decides that she doesn't want to use the hammer because then it wouldn't be fair. And we also get to see the X-Men and the Teen Titans instructed to stop Deathstroke and Darkseid. Axis combined the universe so the brothers would stop fighting, but then he decided it was wrong, so he uncombined them. We get to see Darkseid versus Thanos, and we also get to see the Justice League and the Avengers work together to try to stop them. But then the brothers got mad that the superheroes weren't fighting anymore, so they attacked each other. But then after seeing the reasons why Batman and Captain America became superheroes, they found out that they are both special and that they shouldn't fight. Right, so they start fighting. And they both said the same thing, "You've done well." And I think it's safe to say that we aren't an updated version of it. I think it's safe to say that both sides want a rematch. It could be the peace treaty between Marvel and DC. They could do a team up in the end, and both of the companies could work together on it. And we'll find out who are the best heroes, who are the best villains, who are the best anti-heroes, and who are the best bounty hunters. And it would be great for a movie idea. Do you agree with our top 10 list?
Must not!
Please send me more ideas on our top 10 list you would want me to do.